Her Holiness Sri Mataji Nirmala Devi, Rajesh Shah, press dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure today to talk about something which we have done in Lady Harding Medical College on Sahaj Yoga. Before I tell you what has been done, I tell you how the whole thing started. I heard a lecture of Sri Mataji in 1984, and Sri Mataji gave a realization and said that there is a cool breeze which comes when the self-realization occurs. After the lecture, I met Sri Mataji and I said, Sri Mataji, it could be a subjective phenomena. Anybody can say, when you are asking him, are you getting cool breeze? Are you getting cool breeze? He can say, yes, yes, I feel there is something there. So I said, Sri Mataji, I do not believe in it much. And Sri Mataji was very benevolent and graceful, and she told me, Dr. Rai, you are working in a medical college as head of a department. Why don't you do research and find out what is the truth? This is how the whole story started. And I asked one of my students, postgraduate student, to take the work on Sahaj Yoga, and the whole thing was put in the faculty of the Delhi University, and they approved the subject to find out as to what are the physiological effects of Sahaj Yoga on human body. I will not go into the details. When the thesis of the student got completed and the results were, data was collected and analyzed, statistically, we found very good results. And one of the most outstanding results was that there was a decrease in adrenaline secretion. Adrenaline, we know, when we are in stress, when there is anxiety, this neurotransmitter is produced in the body and is responsible for various harmful effects. For example, high blood pressure, usually, which we get, is due to the greater secretion of adrenaline. And therefore, we thought that the results were so beneficial, so good, that we thought that another student should be given a dissertation. And this time, we worked with the patients in Lady Harding Medical College, in Sustha Kriplani Hospital, in collaboration with the Department of Medicine. We worked on the patients of hypertension, essential hypertension, and we worked on the patient of bronchial asthma. And when after 1 year, when the whole data was collected and analyzed statistically, it was found that it was very helpful as an adjuvant therapy in cases of essential hypertension and also in cases of bronchial asthma. In bronchial asthma as well as in essential hypertension, I may tell you that the cause is not known as yet. The medicine has advanced so much, but still 20% population in the USA suffers from essential hypertension. There is no treatment for this. The various cardiovascular disorders, they say that the risk factor is high blood pressure. And how to tackle this high blood pressure except with the drugs? And the drugs are very toxic. And therefore, even in the recent conferences on cardiology, they have said that in order to tackle hypertension, one of the things is that one has to come to the yoga by meditation. And we found here that in our patients of essential hypertension, when they were doing Sahaj Yoga, their neurotransmitter, that is the concentration of adrenaline, decreased significantly. And that was responsible for the beneficial effect. Similarly, the psychological effect, which is one of the factors of bronchial asthma, was very effectively controlled, and the patients of bronchial asthma who were doing Sahaj Yoga showed remarkable effect. Now, after these two works which we have done, we were very much impressed with the effect of Sahaj Yoga, and we thought of doing some other work. And one day I was talking to Shri Mataji, and she said, Dr. Sahib, you know, epilepsy is a left-sided disease, and it can be cured by Sahaja Yoga. I was really surprised, and I couldn't say anything before her, but I was wondering how Sahaja Yoga can control epilepsy. You see, it did not come to my mind at all. But then you see, when I was reading the literature and I recollected, then I caught hold of one paper of Dr. B. Ram Murthy, a eminent neurosurgeon of Madras, who was the president of the Academy of Medical Sciences. And in one of his, in one of the neurophysiology conferences, he said that he treated the patients of epilepsy by feeding the alpha waves which were stored in a module from the yogis. Now, this gave me a clue. And I thought that instead of storing the alpha waves of the yogis in a module and then giving it to the patients, if we ask the patients to do Sahaj Yoga, their alpha index will increase and the patient may be benefited. So another PhD thesis was taken up. And this time, because at that this time I retired at the time, so I asked one of my friends, Dr. Salva Murthy, who is the director in the Defense Institute of Physiology and Allied Sciences, to take up this job of guiding the thesis of Usha Dudani. And she completed her thesis. This has already been submitted to Delhi University for evaluation. And when we looked at the compiled data of the results, it was really very astounding. We found that even the compact spectral array, the computerized electroencephalography record showed a tremendous effect. You see, it became absolutely normal. And this was really a very good sign. You see. When I went to Russia, you see, I presented this work in the Institute of Neurosurgery in Leningrad. And the chief of the epileptic department was very much impressed by it, and he said, Dr. Rai, we want to do a joint venture research program because there is no treatment for epilepsy. So these things have been scientifically done. Now then, one day Shri Mataji told me, Dr. Rai, this Sahaja Yoga can cure cancer. Again, you see, it was very difficult for me to understand, you see. And for 2 years, you see, I just heard from this side and it went from the other side because it could not come to me at all how Sahaja Yoga, you see, because by Sahaja Yoga we get relaxation. That much part one can understand. But how Sahaja Yoga is going to help in the prevention of cancer was something which was beyond my thinking. But then when she said 2 or 3 times, you see, and in the meantime, you see, I was asked by so many persons during my tour to Russia, Italy and other places to write a book on Sahaja Yoga. And when I was going through the literature, I got a very important hint which Sri Mataji initiated in 1970. Sri Mataji said in 1970 that it is the central heart which is responsible for producing antibodies. She said that if in the childhood or if due to some cause your central heart is catching, the whole of the immune system will get depressed. Now this is a very important thing which in 1977 at a holistic health conference at Toronto called Simonton. You see, he put a psychosomatic model for the treatment of cancer. Now he said this treatment depends on the surveillance theory of cancer. Normally what happens is all of us, sometimes or other, our immune system produces cancer cells. But normally what happens is that our immune system is so strong that they are able to, the cells are able to kill the cancer cells. If somehow these immune systems get depressed, then the cancer cells proliferate and they come into a full-fledged form. And that is how the cancer occurs. This is the theory based on the psychosomatic model on the mind-body relationship was put forward in 1977. And now when we try to analyze this data, we have found that this, the theory of Sri Mataji is very correct, and if somebody is practicing Sahaja Yoga, he might be able to prevent himself from cancer and also from the heart diseases. This is in short, and we have written a book on it. I have written in it how we can prevent cardiovascular diseases, how the stress can be combated or nullified, how the psychiatric disorders can be cured. Thank you very much.